It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these you give and give again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. Stars upon tonight. But I'm a little divided. Do we stay or run away? It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these you give and give again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again.
Yeah. The nature guarantee the secrets. shows. We're gonna be here all night long, motherfuckers. So let's keep singing. Let's keep singing. I'm the voice inside your head you refuse to hear. I'm the face that you have to face, mirrored in your stare. Why was left? Why was right? Why the enemy? I'm gonna handle, take you down, bring you to your sing it out. So who are you? Yeah, who are you? Yeah, why you? Yeah, why you? try to make this life my own. Fly along with me, I can't quite make it known. We'll be right back.
been a long time since we played Los Angeles. I'm gonna fuck you a long time.
For fucking singing that long. The sky is a neighborhood. So keep it down. Oh, it's a storybook. We'll star burn out. The sky is a neighborhood. Don't make a sound. Don't look now. The sky is a neighborhood.
The star burned out. Someone coming up ahead. Don't look now. Oklahoma City, they haven't had a fucking rock show in a year and a half. So every time we come on stage, it's like the best fucking night of our lives. That's what I'm saying. How many people? I don't even want to ask. Who's seen the Foo Fighters before? Some of y'all seen them, right? This is like where we fucking, so I'm, about two-thirds of you motherfuckers on the guest list, I know this. So here's what we're gonna do tonight. We're gonna play as many fucking songs as we can until the fucking show is over. Cause it's been a while. Chris, you can like play whatever you want to play. So, I figure tonight, we do songs from the first record, and the second record, and the third record, and the fourth record, and the fifth record, and the sixth record, and the seventh record, and the eighth record, and the ninth record, and the tenth record. 26 years, we gotta do it tonight! But when you do that, you know what you gotta do? You gotta break that shit down a little bit. Sometimes you gotta break it down. You can't fucking do it hard all night long. Maybe you can, I don't know. But you gotta break it down. Let's do this. Let's fucking do this for a minute. Yeah. Ready, Robbie? Are you ready to fucking break it down? I'm gonna break it down with you.
If you want to, I'll make you feel something real just to bother you. Now I got
under my thumb like a drug. I will smother you. I'll be the one, be the moon, be the sun, be the rain in your song. Put that record on if you want to. I'll be the one, be the tongue that'll swallow you.
Shame, shame, shame.
See my breath. school motherfuckers out there, man. Who's old school? Who's old school?
No, we gotta sing this one again.
You make me dizzy, running circles in my head. One of these days I'll chase your old school motherfucking ass out. You better sing it old school! Come on!
Oh, motherfuckers!
You know you made me break.
Damn, bring the house. dark like that. See all the people. Ladies and gentlemen, here's the fucking deal. We have so many fucking songs that we can't stop. It's true. If y'all want us to play the fucking 225 songs we have, we'll be here for like 6 days. You won't be here for 6 days? Fuck that shit. But when we come out and play gigs and write set lists for you guys, we try to take everybody into consideration, because I know we got some fucking old school, like old school fans. Y'all want to hear the old shit. Yeah, you look old. Yeah, I know what you want. I can tell by looking at you. If you're fucking bald, you got a minivan key in your back pocket, I'm with you, brother. I've got you. But my favorite thing about being in the Foo Fighters is when we play songs that everyone fucking sings along to. I like it when everybody sings. Y'all wanna sing a song? You wanna fucking, we can sing a song if you want. Together in perfect harmony. All right, let's try this one out. And then there's like fucking 20 more we can sing along after that. Old school fans might remember this shit. And for the youngins who've never been to a Foo Fighters show, who's never been to a Foo Fighters show? Let me see it. Where the fuck you been, man? 26 years, you couldn't come to one goddamn show, right? All right. Well, guess what? I'm glad you waited. If you don't know this song, Look at the old bald motherfucker next to you with the minivan keys in his pocket. And just do what he does. That's right. It'll sound good if we do it together. It's called My Hero. It sounds like this.
Too alone now to talk about. Take those pictures down and shake it out. Truth or consequence, say it aloud. Use that evidence, race it around.
Sing it out.
There goes my hero. Watch him as he goes.
That's what I'm talking about, like that.
Don't the best of them read it out, while the rest of them peter out. Truth or consequence, say it aloud. Use that evidence, race it around.
Sing it loud, ready?
Keyboard.
One of these days, the ground will drop out from beneath your feet. One of these days, your heart will stop and play its final beat.
Easy for you to say, your heart has never been broken.
Listen, I don't know what y'all did for the last year and a half. I'll tell you what I did. I fucking waited for this moment the whole fucking time. Because you know what? Right before shit went down, we fucking finished making a record. Good to go. We were like gonna fucking hit the road, take over the fucking world. World domination tour. We had a record, video, fucking movies and shit. And then it went. So we waited. I called my manager. I'm like, can we put out the record yet? He's like, no. Not yet. 2 months later, can we put out the record yet? No. Not yet. 2 months later, put out the record. No. Finally, I was like, it's time to put out the fucking record so people can listen to the fucking music and we can fucking dance around together. And it didn't matter to me yet if we were gonna do it like this. Because for the first time, we made a fucking record you could shake your fucking ass to in your sweatpants on a Saturday night. Cause I know what y'all were doing. You were at home in your fucking sweatpants dancing around the records, drinking cheap white wine in your living room. I know you were. And so was I. I was like. I was like, I need one more box of wine, motherfucker. Anyway. Now. Thank God we're here. Oh my God, it took a long time. But this is the title track to our Saturday Night in Sweatpants album. That's what we should have called the fucking record, Saturday Night Sweatpants. Am I wrong or am I wrong? It's a little number we play sometimes. It's called Medicine. Yeah.
Dancing, yeah.
it. It's been a weird year. Been a weird year. At this point in the program, I feel personally obligated to introduce you to Chris Shiflett, please, lead guitar. Otherwise, we wind up in a band like this.
That's cool!
On the bass guitar, from day one, is Mr. Nate St. Mendel. That motherfucker right there! But that's for Charlie Watts, is what we was doing. Gotta give it up for Charlie, right? I cried at the car wash when I heard that fucking investment. Now, I know that we already gave Rami Jaffe a solo on the piano and the keyboards and shit, but you gotta give it up for Rami on the piano and the keyboards and shit. Charlie, too. You gotta give it up for the ladies singing backups. There's Barbara and Sam and Laura, those badass motherfuckers. And then there's my sweet daughter in a death metal fucking t-shirt. Violet Girl singing on the Foo Fighters, man. You have to understand the fatherly pride when your daughter buys a vintage Mayhem t-shirt off the fucking internet. Father of the year, raising them right. Ladies and gentlemen, you know, we're all kind of from a bunch of other places, but if there's one person that is from Los Angeles, that's Pat Smear on guitar right there. Hold on a second, I didn't say it loud enough. That's Pat Smear on guitar right there. I got a question. First show at the Forum. Rolling Stones with Stevie Wonder. Is that what it was? And then he invented punk rock. So let me hear it one more time for Bassman.
Pat, when you were a kid, did you ever think you would be in the best band in the world playing tonight?
That's a fucking joke. It's supposed to be funny. Last but not least, I'm not gonna let you go home without giving it up for fucking Taylor Hawkins on the drum. That's fucking Taylor Hawkins right there. Taylor?
Dave?
How's your guest list tonight?
Pretty large, isn't it?
Okay, that's good. Well, now you can come down here and sing to all your friends from Laguna Beach, because Taylor Hawkins is gonna come down and sing to all his friends from Laguna Beach. You wanna hear that shit?
Playing the Forum. I remember being up there watching Rush. Way, 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 way the fuck up there. Do you guys want to hear Dave Grohl play the drums?
No. No, no, no. Nope.
I thought I knew a lot about playing drums till I met Dave Grohl.
And then he realized it's the fucking end of the trough position in any band.
That's why he became the singer.
That's right. That's what happened.
All right, fuck it. I never saw Queen here. I wish I did. Pat, you saw Queen here. Can you find me? Can you find me? Do the no one knows thing. Do the no one knows thing. Come on.
Yeah.
Hawkins, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, come on now. Most bands would fucking just say good night. So good night. Unless you want one more. Or two more. Or three more. Or a bunch more. Okay. We can do that. Let's ease into it. I don't want to rush into this shit. Let's ease into it with a nice, simple love song.
Bye.
Okay, so I know that there's like a few people out there that are like hardcore fucking deep cut Foo Fighters fans, right? Just a few. Not everybody. There's a few. So we know that we have to fucking have to play a song for you. And if there's one song we can play for you, it's this song that happens to be one of our favorite songs we've ever written, but we don't really play it too often. So we'll do it for you. It's called Aurora. It sounds like this. Thank you. got one more in you?
Me too.
Let's sing this one fucking loud if you can. Well, I've got another confession to make. I'm your fool. Everyone's got the chains to break. Holding you. Were you born a resent? Won't be of use. We so won't get in the best, the best, the best, the best of you. We so won't get in the best, the best, the best, the best of you. Are you
tired of starting again somewhere new. Were you born to resist?
You got one more in you? Me too. Cool. This one's for the guy in the front row that's like, keep them coming, motherfuckers. It's an old song. It's called Monkey Wrench. Sounds like this.
Abolition is a dead.
fucking scream. You ready to scream? Are you ready to scream? Ready? One, two, one. Scream, motherfuckers! I'll show you how to scream.
One last thing before I quit. I never wanted anymore. I could fit into my head. Still remember everything. What she said. All the shit. Surrounding. Love working. That's what death prevents me. Here we go.
Warm round of applause for Radkey, the band that opened up tonight. They've been on tour with us for a couple, for like a month now.
Fucking Radkey. Emphasis on rad. I like it.
Now look,
yeah,
I'm not going to talk about last year all night long. But if there was one thing that happened to us last year, happened to me last year, it was I wound up meeting someone in the weirdest fucking way ever. I don't want to tell the whole story, but there was this person. There was this person. One day I pick up my phone and my friends are all texting me like, have you seen this shit? And I click on a link, I look at it, and I see that someone is challenging me to a drum off. So I'm like, well, isn't that nice? I kind of brush it off. I'm like, oh, that's kind of funny. All my friends start telling me, no, dude, you gotta step up. This is the real deal. This is a drone challenge. This is a drum off. So I respond. I'm like, all right, I'll play nice. I'll put on a little thing. And then she comes back. And she whoops my fucking ass in front of the entire planet. So I'm like, no, I'm gonna, round three. So I do something else. And she comes back and she kicks my fucking ass again. Tonight was the first night that we met and I came face to face with my arch nemesis. But, of course, this person inspired me last year so much, and I'll tell you why. Because in a time where you would pick up your phone or turn on a computer and all you had was bad news, for that one day, you could pick up your phone and see this connection between two people that have never met making music together and spreading joy and love all across the world. So ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome the most badass drummer in the world, my new friend, Nandy. Everybody gotta say hi, Nandy. Oh wait, she's over here. Look at that! Jam with some pretty amazing people over the years. Maybe some Beatles, maybe some Stones, maybe some Pink Floyds, and some... But let me tell you something. This one right now takes the cake that we get to jam with Nandy right now. Nice shirt. So, how about we do this? We'll celebrate this moment, this incredible reunion. Well, not reunion, never met. We're gonna do this right now. And then I hope, first of all, thank you all very much for coming out to the Rock and Roll Show tonight. I think we should do it again sometime. You know what I mean? Let's do it a lot more. Let's do it, we gotta do a lot more. I always say it, I'm not good at saying goodbye because I know I'll see you all again. If we come back, you all come back, right? Because if you come back, we'll come back too. So, Nandy, this is how we say goodbye.